Hi, I'm here at NIST, where we're learning about these strange substances in a shear thickening fluids. Hey, John. So tell me about shear thickening fluids.
Well, one of the best examples is this strange material known as Oobleck, which gets its name from this Dr. Seuss classic. You can see when I stir the Oobleck slowly, it flows like a normal liquid. But if I stir it too fast, it suddenly becomes much thicker,
right. Almost
solid-like. In fact, it's strong enough to bend my stirrer.
What makes it do that?
Well, scientists debate two opposing theories. In one theory, when you stir too fast, you push the cornstarch particles together, and this makes it really hard for the fluid to flow and get out of the way. In the other theory, when you stir it too fast, you push the particles together so much that they touch, and then you have friction. Now think about stepping on wet sand at the beach. Have you ever noticed that ring of dry sand around your foot? In fact, you can recreate this here with your hand. This happens because you have friction between the sand grains. So when they're jammed in tight together, it's hard for them to move. But if they create some space, they can slide past each other much more easily. This extra space causes the sand to rise and the water level to fall, giving you the ring effect. Our research shows that shear thickening fluids behave very similar to the way the beach sand does. When you stir the Oobleck, the particles push out and try to expand, just like the sand does when you step on it. This tells us that shear thickening is primarily caused by friction, with the fluid forces playing a minor supporting role.
And how does knowing that help us?
Well, shear thickening is important for all sorts of things, like pouring cement, mixing chemicals, and even making new types of body armor.
All right, well, thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.